Hello dear students, now we are going to start with the point angles in linear pair. Okay, so now you can see one figure on the board. Yes, so how many angles are formed in this figure? Yes, we are having two angles in this figure. So the names of the angles are angle PQR and angle SQR. Okay, so the two angles in this figure are PQR and SQR. Okay, so what type of a pair of angle is it? Means these two angles form which pair? So the above angles are forming the pair of adjacent angles and supplementary angle, because if you will see here, is it having common ray QR? Is it having common vertex, these two angles? And they are having separate interior, so they are adjacent angle. Now why are they supplementary angles? If you will see, this is a straight line, and straight line always measures 180 degree. And now there are two angles. Of course, these two angles measurement will be 180. So they also form a pair of supplementary angle. Now which arm, okay, which arm of the angle are not common arm? So you can see QR and QR, means this is a common arm. Then which is not a common arm? QP and QS, means this one, QP and QS. So ray QP and ray QS are not the common arms. Okay, so now this activity is there in your textbook on page number 29. So what you will do, now you will keep your protractor and measure the angle PQR and angle RQS, and you will write the measurement of both of them in the box. What will be its addition, children? Yes, it will surely be 180. Okay, so what we are learning now, that is angles in linear pair. Okay, so the angle PQR and angle RQS in the figure are which angle? They are adjacent angle and also they are supplementary angle. The arms, yes, they are having a common arm, yes, but the arms which are not common are forming pair of opposite rays. See, did I write ray QP and ray QS? So both of them are not common. Yes, they are different arms. But if you will see in the diagram, then are they opposite rays? So they form a pair of opposite ray, and because of that, a straight line is formed. Yes, and this with these angles, we can say that they form a linear pair, yes. So the angles which are adjacent and which are supplementary, and their arm which is not common and forms a straight line, such angles form a pair of linear pair. Okay, so the measure sum, okay, so the sum means addition. Okay, the sum of the measures of the angles in linear pair is always 180. Okay, so you can say, in short, angles in linear pair and supplementary angles, are they same? Yes, they are same. Okay, so angles which have a common arm, okay, and whose other arm form a straight line, are said to be angles in linear pair. Also, angles in linear pair are supplementary angles. Did you understand about linear pair angles? Okay.
these are the notes about angles in linear pair. Write down it in your CW. You can also take help of page number 29 while writing the notes.
Now just look at the figure 2. Okay. In figure 2, you can see two angles. Is it? What is the measure of angle ABC? It is 140 degree. And measure angle XYZ is 40 degree. Yeah. Now one is obtuse angle, other is acute angle. Yes. Now if we will add these two angles, 140 and 40 degree, what will be its addition? It will be 180 degree. Then which pair of angle it is? It is a pair of supplementary angle. Okay. Now if you look in figure 1, then in figure 1 also you are having two angles, PQR and RQS. Yes. If you will see, the down line is a straight line, is of course it is 180 degree. So these two are also pair of supplementary angle. But today we have learned that this is also called as a pair of angles in linear pair. Now see the difference. These two angles, children, they are 140 plus 40, that is 180, they form 180, and they are called as a supplementary angles. Even these angles are also called supplementary angles because they also measure 180 degree. But these angles are also called as angles in linear pair because they have a common arm. They have the arm which is not common is forming a pair of opposite rays, okay, and they are also adjacent angles, yeah, and so these angles are also called angles in linear pair. But this here, are they adjacent to each other? No. Do they have uncommon arm as a opposite ray? No. So these are called only supplementary angle, but these are called as angles in linear pair and also supplementary angles. So always remember, children, angles in linear pair are supplementary angles, okay, but all supplementary angles are not angles in linear pair. Now we'll begin with practice set 19. Here the question is, draw the pairs of angle as described below. Since this will be the description, according to that you have to draw the pairs of angles. Now if that is not possible, say why. Okay, so the first description is complementary angles that are not adjacent. Now first of all, children, think that you all know the measurement of complementary angle is 90 degree. Yes, so you can show inside also, yeah, two angles in this way. Suppose one is 30 degree, then other will be 60 degree. So these two angles, are they complementary? Yes, they are complementary because their addition is 90 degree. And they are adjacent also, yeah. Common arm, common vertex, separate interior. But can you draw complementary same these two angles in this way also? Suppose this is 60 degree. And this is 30 degree. Can you say these two are complementary? Yes, they are complementary because 60 plus 30 is 90. But are they adjacent now? No. So did you understand? So for this question or for this description, how will be your diagram? Yes, your diagram will be in this manner. See, yeah? Complementary angles, are they complementary 60 plus 30? Yes, that are not adjacent. These are not adjacent. Here it is adjacent. So this will be your answer. Did you understand? So how will be answer? You have to use protractor, children. You will draw any two angles whose addition will be 90 degree. Yeah? Now I am taking 60 degree, you have to use protractor and scale, okay? Label it A, B, C, 60 degree. Other, if I am taking 30, use protractor, okay? So this is P, Q, R. Are you able to draw this pairs of angles? Yes, we have drawn it. See, now other measurement you can also take 80 plus 10. Yeah, 45, 45, 55, 35. Any two measurements you can take whose addition will be 90 degree and make complementary angle. So this is the answer for the first description. Second question, that is angles in linear pair which are not supplementary. Now we have learned in the earlier question that angles in linear pair are supplementary, but here they are saying draw which will not be supplementary. Is it possible? No, it is not possible. Why? Because the angles in linear pair are always supplementary. You have to write that reason. So this is the answer for the second question. Third question, that is complementary angle that do not form a linear pair. Now see children, complementary angles are 90 degree and linear pair are 180 degree. Yeah. So can we draw complementary angle? Of course they will not be a pair of linear pair because they are 90 and they are 80. So this will be a answer. Use protractor while drawing the or constructing the diagram. Question is adjacent angles which are not in a linear pair. We all know that the angles in linear pair are always adjacent. Yeah, but we have to draw adjacent angles, but they should not be in a linear pair. Can we draw? Yes, we can draw. Any one obtuse angle you take, don't take a straight angle, okay? Obtuse angle, and you can show any measurement. First draw, suppose you are drawing 120 degree angle. Draw it, and inside any two different angles you can mark. Yeah, that is, suppose now this is 50 degree, then what will be this? 70 degree, okay? You use protractor, children, while constructing a D, E, F, B, name it like this, okay? So these are adjacent. Are they adjacent? But they are not linear pairs. Now, angles which are neither complementary nor adjacent. Complementary angles are 90 degree. Adjacent angles means they should be joined, yeah, but separate interior. We don't want complementary also and we don't want adjacent also, yeah. So complementary means 90 degree, yeah. So you can draw any two angles whose addition will be less than 90 or more than 90, okay, and draw it in a separate way. If you join them, then it will become adjacent. We don't want adjacent, so draw it in a separate way. For example, if I am drawing here, this is for example 60 degree. Then give it name P, Q, R. Now if I take 30, will it be complementary? So don't take 30. Take either make it small, means less than 90, or make it more than 90. Suppose I am giving, suppose this angle is 20 degree. That is X, Y, Z. Then 60 plus 20, 80. Is it complementary? No. Is it adjacent? No. So we are able to draw the diagram. The last question, that is the sixth question, that is angles in a linear pair which are complementary. Are we able to draw? No, it is not possible because we know that angles in linear pair are always supplementary. So you have to write that reason. This is the answer or the solution for the sixth question. Now you will write the notes what we have discussed, and after that you are going to solve practice set 19 in your CW in neat and clean handwriting.